Welcome to the episode of Locked In. This episode is going to be on the Tiger Lock. Have you ever wanted an ultra lightweight weenie bike lock for your bike? No? Well, now you do. You spend all this money buying a carbon fiber bike that weighs like 3 pounds, and then what do? You strap a 50 pound U-lock on there to keep it safe?
But no more!
The Tiger Lock is a titanium, ultra lightweight bike locking solution for your bike. Now they have multiple different sizes and combinations, but we're going to be going over specs, ease of use, features, and price. They do have a couple of different sizes on their website that you can check out with the link below. The one I got was the mini. That one's gonna be weighing in at just 0.4 kilograms. And honestly, most of that weight is in the locking mechanism. Once you remove that thing, this lock feels like nothing. This lock is roughly gonna be about 10 inches total length and about 4 to 5 inches in width. But the bottom portion where you slide your frame in is expandable, so keep that in mind. Now onto features. This is gonna feature, obviously, a titanium lock with a key actuated locking mechanism. It's a lock-in cylinder, so once you put the key in, you want to hold the outside of the cylinder so it doesn't spin internally. Then you're going to twist the key and open it. The nice thing is once you're done locking the bike up, you just simply press the button. Also, it features a mounting clip that will replace your water bottle so you can mount the lock on your frame if you desire. Also, it's going to feature a unique key, which is going to have a little badge on there that you want to take a picture of so you can save it for later because that is going to be your code to where if you need to order more keys, you can through Tiger. Now let's get on to ease of use. The shape of it is designed to go through the frame and your wheel ideally, and the little bulbous part on the one side is to wrap around a pole or a bike rack. Using the mini lock, you are constrained by certain widths of poles or bike racks, but most of them that you're gonna find are fine. Now I wanted to test this mainly on my cross bike. The reason being is for most people who are commuting or locking up their bikes, it isn't gonna be their ultra skinny wheeled carbon frames on the road bikes, it's probably gonna be a hybrid or a cross bike or some kind of more comfortable commuter. That's why I wanna test this lock with that frame. So because of my bigger tires and the bigger frame clearances and my larger tubing on my cross bike, it was a little difficult when I wasn't locking it up to a bike rack. Check out their website because they do have other models that are more versatile and they even have an extra long lock that'll lock the front, the frame, and the rear wheel all in one. I went with the mini because I wanted something that was easy to throw in my bike bag. And when you're using it, like I mentioned before, the lock can expand once you open it, so there is some play. It's not a rigid lock like a U-lock typically would be. And the locking mechanism in the cylinder lock felt really solid. Now you do have to hold the exterior of the locking mechanism, like I mentioned before, so that it doesn't twist, because if you look at the shape of the bottom of the lock, it is just a groove section that the cylinder spins around. So you need to use the key to unlock the lock, but you don't need it to re-lock it. Lastly, price. Now this lock is going to be on the higher end. It is going to be $99. That includes two keys, a locking mount, and the lock in this size. Now you are going to be paying a little bit of a premium for this lock, but you're getting a solid locking mechanism and an ultra lightweight lock that's easy to bring with you. Especially if you have a longer commute, this will definitely pay dividends as far as your comfort on your daily smash commute, Cat 1 commuter ride. So my final thoughts on this, it is definitely a unique lightweight lock that is definitely going to be different than what you're going to find at most bike shops. But it provides a commuter a easy lightweight solution and a safe lightweight solution to locking up their bike. This fresh minimalistic approach to the locking system, I really like and I definitely would recommend it. Now, when you are locking your bike, they do recommend the Sheldon Brown method, which I'll provide in the links below. So depending on what kind of bike you have and tire size, you might have to get a bigger lock than I have. The Sheldon Brown method is when you lock the rear wheel and the frame to whatever you're locking it to. Make sure to like and subscribe. Make sure to check the Facebook out and the Instagram. Links are all in the description and a direct link to Tiger's website. So thanks for watching another episode of Locked In. Let's get locked in today. Bike tutorials and quick and fix tips. Let's get locked in today. You'll be a pro by the time I'm done with this. Wait, hold on
a second.
We need a towel, we need a nap.
What?
You're getting sweaty, bro.
I'm gonna sweat.
We got powder. Powder on camera.
Makeup.
Okay.
Okay, good.
That in there? Boom.